19 years ago, a researcher saw a strange arc in some data. Nearly two decades later, we finally know what it was, an ultramassive black hole. No matter how much we hear about them or how much they appear in our fiction, black holes remain a great mystery to scientists. Because of how difficult it is to detect them, and how difficult it is to directly observe them even once detected, there's a lot we don't know about these huge gravity wells. Therefore, every time we discover a new one, we can learn a lot from its observation. Especially if it's part of an underclass that crosses the boundaries or has been discovered in an unusual way. In an exciting turn of events for researchers, the one featured in this new study falls into both categories. Ultramassive black holes are some of the largest single objects we know of, tens of billions of times larger than our Sun. This particular black hole, which is about 30 billion times the mass of our Sun, is one of the largest ever detected and is at the upper limit of the size we think black holes can theoretically reach. This monster was found in a really interesting way. That strange arc in the data that started the process of this discovery was an artifact produced by an effect known as gravitational lensing, making it the first black hole to be found using that method. Gravitational lenses basically consist of using an object in the universe as a telescope. It is often used to find exoplanets. If scientists want to see if a particular star hosts other worlds, but is too far away for them to see in detail, they can position themselves so that another object is directly between us and the target. Light coming from the target is bent and amplified by the gravity of the object in between, allowing scientists to analyze the light from the target in more detail and detect things that might have gone unnoticed. But interestingly, looking at the gravitational lensing data allows one to see information about more than just the target. It also allows you to collect information about the object in between. And that's exactly what happened with this newly discovered ultramassive black hole. The researchers analyzed the effect that the gravity of the object in the middle had on the light from the object behind it. Once they saw the result, they ran multiple simulations to calculate the mass the central object had to have to generate the gravitational effect they observed. And they discovered that the central galaxy must harbor an ultramassive black hole of 30 billion solar masses. This method has not only allowed scientists to investigate one of the largest black holes ever found, but has also given them hope that they can use gravitational lensing to find black holes in the future. It would be especially useful for finding quiescent black holes, which are currently impossible to study at great distances because they don't produce the radiation we usually use to detect them.